Moving on to the next one. The two lamps, one rated at 100 watts, 220 volt, and other 60 watt, 220 volt, are connected in parallel to electric main supply. What current is drawn from the line if the supply voltage is 220 volt? So what they given? They given two different lamps. One is 100 watts, another one is 60 watts, which is operated at 220 volt AC main, right? So what is the total current from that circuit they are asking? So the current will be passing here. The first thing, they given as parallel connection, voltage remains same and current will be varied in each and every appliances. So the bulb 2 also current varied, bulb 1 also current varied, because of these are connected in parallel, right? Okay. So what they given? The voltage, power supply voltage, they given as 220 volt, and the power of the first bulb 100 watts. Here they given 100 watts, that is the unit of power. So the power of the first bulb P1 is equal to 1000 watts. Power of second bulb is P2 is equal to 60 watts. They are asking total current I. And what is the formula we are going to use here? P1 divided by V, that is equal to I1, and P2 divided by V is equal to I2. Since these are all parallel connection, voltage remains same. So only the power is varied. So the power varies with respect to the voltage that will use individual current to that lamp. Therefore, I can be written as I1 plus I2. Now we are going to find out the I1 value. So I1 is equal to P1 divided by V1. So what is the power of first bulb? 100 divided by voltage value, 220. So 100 divided by 220, 10 by 22. That can be written as 5 by 11. 5 by 11 means 0.45. How we can? So 50 divided by 11. So initially 5 we cannot divide by 11, right? For that I put 1 0. So 50 in the sense 4 times 44, 60, then it becomes 5 times. So 0.45 ampere. And similarly for second one, I2 is equal to, what is the power of second bulb? 60. 60 divided by voltage is 220. So 60 divided by 220, 6 by 22. That can be written as 3 by 11. So 3 by 11, if you are simplifying, that will give 0.27 ampere. So I1 we found, I2 we found. Therefore, the total current I is equal to I1 plus I2. So 0.45 plus 0.27 is equal to 0.72 ampere. So this is the total current passing the circuit. I hope you understand well. See you in the next video.